This is a best of seven women's singles finals. Love all. First point to Wu Yang. Kasumi knows she's gonna have to put the pressure on when she can. At the same time, patience against choppers. Very few people beat choppers rushing the shots. So Wu Yang takes both of her serves for points to start it off. And completely fooling Kasumi Ishikawa, leaving it out to the forehand side. Look at this again. Sees her turning the corner, just touches it at the last moment out wide. Powerful counterattack with the forehand from the middle of the table. There's something very carnal about this. I feel like Wu Yang is just sort of demonstrating right now that she has threats all over. Close to the table, she can attack with the forehand, she can chop, she can receive. Short side of the table, look at that ball. Right down the line and hooking, and Coach Yan Sen, doubles champion with Wang Liqin in 2000. Wide angle, smart play. Kasumi Ishikawa taking it off the bounce earlier on, bringing Wu Yang in a little bit. A little bit of top spin, I think, will help the shots, the power. Kasumi's able to get more control and more pace when the ball's jumping into the racket instead of biting the table and staying close to the net. Unbelievable footwork. Wu Yang is able to get in from over the table after such a touch drop shot there by Kasumi. Not able to play the other attack, and that smart play. Wu Yang, as a chopper, comes running in and pushes it deep into the backhand because she knows she's out of position. Flat hit crushes it right behind Wu Yang. Coach Chun Li Lee. Again, a very humorous team of practice partners, coaches for Kasumi Ishikawa. Deep push, not lifted enough. As far as experience goes, defenders tend to be quite versatile, masters of spin, comfortable at lifting and looping their own heavy pushes coming back. Well, Ishikawa definitely knows that she's gonna have to pull out some extraordinary play. Still has had trouble with the varying amounts of backspin. Again, short pips on the backhand side, the red side of the racket for Wu Yang. She can vary the spin a little bit more. And game one is getting away from Ishikawa. Steady spin, right down the middle from Ishikawa. flat hit and murders that ball. Not as easy as it looks. We've seen many people hit that ball into the bottom of the net. A little high and closer to the net. Oh, game point here. Game point saved. Maybe I misunderstood the point before. Either way, Ishikawa saves a game point. Inside out forehand, bending away, and Wu Yong with authority, 11-5 in game one. Beautiful shot. A nice catch from Ishikawa, but it counts for nothing. Wu Yong, very difficult to tell where she's going to hit the ball. And again, forehand attacks from defenders to finish the point, punish high balls closer to the table in general. And this time a little bit deeper on the court, on the table rather. Spins it up from far back. Power, a fist clinch, and a first point for Ishikawa in game two. Really working the angle there, playing it wide to the backhand. This is one more reason that Wu Yong is going to have to try and stay closer to the table. Ooh, there's another one. Two bounces on top. Fortune for Ishikawa off the top of the net. Inside out forehand attempt, and it's loaded with backspin. Now remember, Wu Yong only dropped a game once in this tournament, to Poland's Natalia Partyka. After that, hasn't lost a single game, not even to the top seed. Stays on Wu Yong's side of the table. It's a 1-point game. Ishikawa just down by one. Opening up with the backhand can vary the spin, create some trouble for the defender. Takes great confidence from the attacker, of course. But twice in a row with the opening backhand, this time it comes back into play. Unbelievable. Two huge chops off of some of the best shots I've seen from Kasumi Ishikawa, and then right back in for the inside out forehand attack. Look at Wu Yong flaunting here. Really just flaunting what she's got with that short stroke across the body, inside out forehand. Ball was way out in front when she hit it too. So much spin on that last ball. Ishikawa touches it and it flies. Short side of the table overlooked. Haven't seen Wu Yong miss too many forehand attacks yet. Ishikawa showing some fire and some hope. Still early in the match. Again, last time they played, it went 7 games. And the comeback has started. Will it continue? Second towel break of the game. Ishikawa settling into a rhythm here. Table tennis is definitely a brainy sport. It's always a puzzle. You're trying to figure out your opponent, think tactically, how to beat them. But against defenders, I feel like it takes a little extra brain power. Yeah, it really forces the thinking. Such a hard forehand. And the chop again, so loaded. But Ishikawa really keeping the racket speed up and reading it just right. Ball stayed low off the bounce. Quite difficult to lift from out in front. Oh no, the short side of the table's open. It's another 4-game points for Wu Yang. Break off the top of the net, but the backhand punch, top of the net again goes out. Game points saved here. Excellent recovery. And that's the time for Ishikawa when she gets a little bit of topspin to try and play quick off the bounce, but no luck there. She's coming out of the gate swinging, looking for opportunities to put the pressure on. She's earned herself some high shots here and there, some high balls in the rallies. Takes a lot of work though, and they're still not easy shots to make. Softer spinny backhand. A little bit out in front of Wu Yang. So far, the backhand spin shot early on in the rally has been effective. 2 out of 3 times I recall seeing it anyway from Ishikawa. Soft touch keeps the ball low enough that Wu Yang can't put it away with the backhand punch. That time she can. Give me another chance, she says. Proves herself. And steady chopping from the backcourt. Haven't seen too many errors in the chopping game for Wu Yang. Again, a little more trouble with the backhand spin shots from Ishikawa. Not too many players prefer attacking chops, though. Opening up with the backhand is one thing. But attacking mid-rally with the backhand is another. Krianga and Karakosovic, two of the best backhands, are most dominant over their forehand anyway. I've seen play choppers and hit winners with their backhand. There's that serve again, the one that looks like it's going to jump out into the forehand side. And then kicks out wide into the backhand corner. Excellent reach. Gets in early to take the ball wide and deep to the backhand. This is what happens when a short receive is just a little bit too high. Realize Ishikawa has to swing and avoid the back of the table while still getting that loop over the table. Full stroke, excellent precision, and execution, of course. Outstanding point. The inside-out forehand attack comes right back. Anticipated by Ishikawa and covering. Again, a lot of people so focused on their big stroke that they don't get back for the forehand attack. Don't cover, get into the blocking game well enough against choppers. But Ishikawa has recovered from that mistake in the past. Kicking serve into the body, jams up Wu Yang. Sets up the third ball attack for Ishikawa with this inside-out forehand. And Ishikawa's always looking for the serve. She's got a wide variety of serves up her sleeve. And now we're looking at tie game. First game was 11-5 for Wu Yang. After that, it was 11-7. So Ishikawa on track to continue improving. Loaded chop a little bit high, and you can see the frustration from Ishikawa pulling on the shirt, much like Chen Weixing with the shorts. Wu Yang drying off the ball. That is the responsibility of the server. If the server loses the point because the ball's wet, they lose the point outright. If the receiver loses the point because of a wet ball, they show the wet mark to the umpire and the point will be replayed. The angles again, Ishikawa earning the short ball on the forehand side. This setup has worked quite well. Fast long serve into the backhand for the point. Tied up at 8 each. And again, a master of varying her serves. Kasumi Ishikawa is finding some real effective serves right now. Counterattack, too much pressure there. Ishikawa keeping it low, deep on the table. And look at the ball that Wu Yang has to deal with here. How low that is. By the time she hits it, stroke has to take the ball way out in front. Shot selection when you're going to attack as a defender, definitely very important. Shot selection is always important for every player. Pushed out wide to the forehand side. The lead disappears into the third towel break. They're tied up. Ishikawa 2 points away from taking the game. So far, just continuing the pattern, though, of improving by 2 points. And the serve into the backhand. It's Wu Yang trying to get some side spin on that receive. Strong variation again, and Ishikawa now with a game point. Second serve to take it here. Beautiful shot right off the bounce after the inside out forehand takes it deep to the backhand corner. Kasumi Ishikawa now with some hope and some ideas out here. Just overshooting to the middle of the table for the first point. It seems like Wu Yang is going to try to avoid leaving it short on the forehand side. Fast long serve to the middle, but the chop that comes back, Ishikawa just underestimated. And the push well placed. Again, the Wu Yang forehand hasn't been missed too much, but Ishikawa's really honing in, dialing in on keeping her shots low, well placed, whether it's a push or a spin shot into the Wu Yang forehand. Outright service. Tough to see the contact on that, but again, defenders no spin quite well. It's pretty rare to see a defender not able to return a serve. And there it is this time, comes around the outside of the ball. The reverse serve. And quick follow up with the wide angle deep into the backhand corner. This is one way to get points early against a defender. It's not easy to do. Typically, patient play is rewarded. But if you have a plan, take it confidently and it's working by all means. Ooh! I don't think that caught the top of the table. Wu Yang apologizes. Kasumi says no, sorry, didn't make it. Let's see from here, side of the table. Kasumi, nope, no you didn't. And the streak continues, Ishikawa back in a 2-point lead. The way the point before ended, so interesting, sort of distracted from how strong the smashes were before and all the chops coming back from so far from the table. There it is, right off the bounce. A little bit of topspin is breakfast for Ishikawa. She's done this several times, recognizes a good opportunity for an honest, quick bounce. Inside out, a little bit of side spin on it too, but no problem, starts her swing early and makes Wu Yang pay for the big forehand before out wide. Loaded again, difficult ball. Ishikawa's been pretty strong, staying on the attack. Has won the majority of her points attacking. Of course, that's going to be typical. Most shots, or most rallies aren't going to end with pushing against a chopper. Short side of the table, a little bit too short. Ball a little bit too long. And after such a touch shot, floating it back with a little side spin into the backhand, settling back into the looping game is trouble for Ishikawa. Fast footwork from Ishikawa. Deep out on the forehand side, comes right back to the backhand corner. But the point doesn't continue. Back to her pendulum serve, kicking into the body. Sometimes she was doing a reverse serve that was bending the other way. Completely fools Wu Yang. Has her going the wrong way, hits it behind her, and a recovery receive. Still with plenty of spin on it. High toss, subtle contact. Just not enough lift on that last ball. All those chops coming back fast and low. Ishikawa trying to vary up her placement on the table. Generally safer hitting it deep to the backhand, has won a lot of points that way. But stretched out wide a little bit late to get there, has less options. Too many times this game we've seen that happen. Ishikawa getting in a good position to loop, just being overpowered or misreading the spin. Looping it into the bottom of the net. Outstanding play again, this time to the short side of the table, and as soon as the topspin comes back, it seems like the percentages go way up for Ishikawa to take it off the bounce and play the angles. From that far away, Wu Yang doesn't have the control and authority that she wants with that topspin, and Ishikawa has too much time to react. And the defensive game. Heavy spin from Wu Yang comes right back in, and Ishikawa backed off the table. It's now two game points for Wu Yang. And at times this game seemed within reach, a very important game. Could be pivotal, the turning point if Ishikawa's able to take it. It's still not over, just 2 points away from deuce. But in the push game, the threat of the attack on the forehand side from Wu Yang was waiting. It's 11 points to 8. Down the short side of the table. Surprise, surprise, nobody's home. Big forehand there from Kasumi Ishikawa. Again, takes a lot of confidence to hit that ball. So much underspin on it. Just missing down the middle. Tucking in the shirt, seemed a little bit distracted by the shirt. And the shirt tuck works. I was thinking I would be distracted just having one piece of the shirt tucked in. But very aggressive play this game, living boldly early on. And that's that serve that kicks out wide to the backhand. High toss, subtle touch. Again, with the high toss serve, the ball's coming down faster, so it tends to have a bit more action. You can create more spin and more speed. Just takes more precise touching and control. Ball up and out, still a 1 point lead for Ishikawa. Oh, back edge for Ishikawa, a little break. 4 points to two. Again, the spin variation from the short pips on the backhand of Wu Yang. Sometimes a little heavier, sometimes floats it back. The inside out forehand goes long. The lead has disintegrated, tied up. I think that's right for Ishikawa to go for the inside out forehand. Try to get some top spin balls back on the forehand side from Wu Yang. This time the top spin comes back, but Ishikawa's stuck in the backhand corner. Quick point. The backhand opening, another way that Ishikawa's managed to get some points early on. Giving a top spin shot that's slightly less familiar to Wu Yang. Side spin comes back. Short side of the table's open, and Ishikawa takes it. Back in the lead. When you see Wu Yang start to turn out of the corner of your eye, it changes the pressure on your shot. Feel a little extra pressure to keep the ball low. This is again why the modern game of defense needs an attack, a strong attack on the forehand side. Loaded with spin deep on the table. Catches the edge of the racket. Look at where she tries to take this ball. Very back of the table, just under. Top of the net, but it stays on Ishikawa's side. It's becoming trouble. 3 points in a row for Wu Yang. Difficult ball, that last one I was pretty confident would go into the net, but Ishikawa managed to lift it from out in front. Two big shots, stays on the aggression. Look at this last ball. See where it bounces way over the table. Lunges out for it. And now just a 1 point game with her second serve. Oh, has the opportunity. Says, why not go to the short side of the table? In many senses, the safer shot was the shot she just took. Trying to play the angle out wide. Crowd wants to see the match continue, showing their support for the underdog, Kasumi Ishikawa. Backhand goes up and out, and it is three championship points for Wu Yang. Could be the first chopper to ever win this title. And the big forehand does it. It is Wu Yang. Congratulations. The 24-year-old, world ranked number 10 and third seed in this tournament, does it. Defense rules the world here at the German Open. And what a performance to take down the second seed, world ranked number 5, Kasumi Ishikawa.